these are one of the few I do enjoy with ice.
How it translates.
This looks interesting.
Yes, it is.
What are we tasting?
This is a white Pinotage from Wellington Wines.
White Pinotage?
Mm-hmm. So, what a few people know is that only the skin of a grape is red. And so you can essentially make a white wine from any red grape. So they just don't allow any skin to touch the juice as it presses.
Interesting. I haven't seen a lot of white Pinotage around.
I think there's only maybe a handful of producers that make it. I know there's also a white cab available, and I know people are experimenting with it, but only a few Americans. It's not typical white wine nose, flavors. You would never have guessed it.
Typical white wine acidity reminds me of Sauvignon Blanc.
Definitely.
Smelling it on the nose, tasting it on the palate, there's nothing that gives away to me that this came from a red wine grape.
It's funny you should say that because there's customers who actually say that they notice some of the vintage aspects like the banana on the nose, but I think you really have to focus down on it to pick it up. It's actually just another white, refreshing wine that you can enjoy, just like another one that we have.
Cool, and it's nice and unique. It's something different.
Yeah.
And yeah, I like that.
Yeah, it's amazing.
It's a great summer
drink. Definitely.
But something that's been so interesting to me, especially over the last 6 months, has been how insignificant the products we sell actually are to our regular customers. Yes, we've got a great wine. Yes, we've got an awesome list of cocktails. Yes, we have great craft beers. We've got, you know, really cool spirits and stuff that's a little bit different, and everything is of a really high standard. But when people come here, what they enjoy most is interacting with our staff.
Our funny hats.
Yeah.
The red feather boa. For me, that's the cool thing about the group, is everyone knows what it is in terms of our product offering. But only the guys that come regularly actually know that there's so much more.
Yeah.
That our staff are really engaging. We really focus on our customer service, and we treat our guests really well. So how long have you been working?
It's probably almost 6 months.
What's the funniest or craziest thing that you've witnessed at the group?
I always miss out on all the fun. I just hear the stories about guests jumping off tables.
That has happened.
Body shots being done in the bar.
That's also happened.
A birthday guest who was standing on the bar. You were there. That was what I witnessed. She was standing on the bar, singing happy birthday to herself, not knowing, and none of us knowing that the bar is fixed.
Right, highly ugly style on very unstable bar. Yes, no, it is. Is not for standing. I also think that's a cool thing. We do a lot of birthday parties.
Yeah.
We have a lot of people booking big groups coming in here and making the space their own.
Yeah.
And I think that's so cool that it's kind of intimacy where when people come in and they bring their friends, they really feel like it's their space.
Yeah.
And if you have a group that's, you know, the dominant group on the evening, you make it your own.
Yeah.
And you, to an extent, within limits, do what you would want to do.
Yeah.
And we're quite flexible and open to that sort of thing. You know, if you want to have a party and you want to bring a birthday cake and put balloons up and throw glitter everywhere, which has also happened. We were mopping that up for a few weeks. No, it's a cool thing that we're building.
Yeah.
Not that we have built, but that we're building. It's a process. And what's exciting is it's just getting better.
Yeah.
It's so much better than it was on day one. It's 100 times better than it was a year ago.
Yeah.
And in general, it's just every single week that goes by, it's